Now, what we can do? We can analyze this situation by constructing a simple payoff matrix, which we learned in our basic microeconomics and principles of economics. Let us analyze this case. Let us say that there are only two countries in the world, and each country has two strategies, either to go for cooperation, that means pollution reduction, which will lead to low level of pollution, or non-cooperation, which will lead to high pollution. So, let us say that this is low pollution for player 1 or country 1. This is for country 1. What are the strategies? Low pollution and high pollution. Similarly, for country, sorry, this is country 2, and we will put country 1 left side. So, they are also low and high. And the payoffs are like this, 1, 2, minus 1, 5, 2, minus 3, and 0, 0. This is for country 2 and this is for country 1. So, country 1 is this side, country 2 is that side. Now, out of this payoff matrix, let us try to find out the equilibrium or solution. Let us assume that country 2 decides to cooperate, that means to emit only lower level of pollution, then what is better for country 1? If country 1 goes for cooperation, it gives 1, it gets 1. By non-cooperation, that means generating high level of pollution, it gets 2. So, obviously, when country 2 goes for low, that means cooperation, non-cooperation or high level of pollution is better for country 1. Similarly, when country 2 goes for non-cooperation, generates high level of pollution, if the country 1 generates low, then it will get minus 1. If the country goes for high level of pollution, it is get 0. Since 0 is greater than minus 1, country 1 will go for high level of pollution. So, that means one thing is clear. Irrespective of whatever country 2 does, non-cooperation or generating high amount of pollution is better for country 1. That is why we say that a high pollution or non-cooperation is a dominant strategy for country 1. What we said? Non-cooperation is a dominant strategy for country 1. Similarly, if we think from country 2's point of view, if country 1 goes for low level of pollution, then country 2 should go for high level of pollution because 5 is greater than 2. When country 1 goes for high level of pollution, country 2 should go for high level of pollution because 0 is greater than minus 3. That means country 2 also has a dominant strategy. So, that means we can say that when country 1 goes for low level of pollution, country 2 should go for high. So, high is better for country 2 because 5 is greater than 2. We are denoting the best strategy by a star mark. Similarly, when country 1 goes for high level of pollution, country 2 should go for high level of pollution because 0 is greater than minus 3. Now, the cell consisting of best strategies, best responses of country 1 and 2 is actually the equilibrium. This is called Nash equilibrium in the literature of game theory. Right? Now, this particular equilibrium has an interesting feature. What is this? That means the solution of this game shows, even though cooperation is better for both the countries, cooperative solution is 1, 2, which is greater than 0.0. See, at cooperation, both the countries are better off. At non-cooperation, leads to Pareto suboptimal situation. So, this Nash equilibrium is actually Pareto suboptimal. Why this is suboptimal? In terms of the diagram also we can understand that when they are not cooperating, that is leading to lower level of global abatement, more pollution, which is bad for all the countries. But still, they are not able to reach at the cooperation. Why? Because each country has a dominant strategy in non-cooperation. Each country has a dominant strategy of non-cooperation. That means high pollution. High pollution. Because of this existence of a dominant strategy in terms of non-cooperation, countries are not able to arrive at cooperation. Right? And that is basically the classic problem of not getting a solution for the global climate change or global warming problem. Right? So, with this simple model, this model of two countries can easily be extended to N country game, and with that extension we can easily understand why this is so problematic, so difficult to control global pollution. It is a free riding problem. Each country has a tendency to deviate from the cooperation because that deviation gives better outcome. So, when all the countries are thinking in the same line of non-cooperation, non-cooperation and non-cooperation is becoming the solution of the game, which is leading to more pollution, which is bad for the country. Then how to solve this free riding problem? So, what is the solution? See, when the countries are deciding to cooperate, that means At this level, when the countries are deciding about this level, this is for cooperating solution. Now, we should understand one thing, that different countries are at their different level of their development. For example, India is at a particular stage of its development, China is at a particular stage of its development, UK, US, France, Canada, all these countries, they are in a particular level of their development. Now, at this stage, if the country decides to go for global agreement and to reduce the pollution, let's say all the country decides to reduce the pollution by 2%, then this solution, this situation, this cooperating solution becomes problematic for some of the countries. Some of the countries may worse off if they go for cooperation. Why? Because the poorer countries, they have just started their growth process, developmental process, which requires production of more goods and services. So, at this stage, if they are also bound to reduce their pollution, that means they need to reduce their production activities, which will hamper their growth and development. Developed nations, they have already achieved so much of development in their country. So, they can afford to go for such cooperation and then they can reduce the pollution. While others who have not traveled so much in the developmental path, it becomes really problematic for those countries to come for such cooperation. So that means we need to design a side payment. Economists, they say that we need to design a side payment. Since some countries are worse off at the cooperation, then what we need to do, if we see that the global benefit, if global benefit of cooperation, is higher, much higher than the loss of some specific countries, then the countries who are getting benefit out of this cooperation, they should actually compensate the loss of these countries. If the losses of these countries are compensated by a side payment, then only there is a chance that these countries will also go for such cooperation, cooperating activities to reduce pollution globally. And such a side payment can actually solve the problem of free riding. Without such side payment, it is very difficult to achieve cooperation, to achieve international agreement for pollution reduction. But the question is, then how will you design the side payment? What type of side payment? How will you distribute the side payment? Whether that will actually be paid or not? So that means this side payment mechanism should be a credible one. So it should be credible side payment. So that means countries, all the countries should be convinced that this is the way other countries are going to compensate the poorer countries, then only they will cooperate and we can solve the problem of transboundary pollution or international externalities. Unfortunately, even though theoretically it sounds good, countries could not achieve such type of side payment even now. That is why even in the 21st century also we see the threat of global warming, because they have not yet come up with some credible side payment mechanism that can actually convince all the countries to cooperate, that can convince all the countries to avoid such free riding problem. So countries should put more effort to this mechanism of side payment if the global benefit is higher than the loss of some of the countries. So with this, this is basically the summary of transboundary pollution. So what we discussed basically in short, that certain type of pollution are transboundary in nature, because pollution does not respect the political boundary. And classic example of such transboundary pollution or international externality is acid rain, global warming. These are all examples of transboundary pollution. No supranational government exists to impose any type of market-based instrument on a specific country where the pollution is getting generated. That's why the mechanisms we discussed earlier in the context of national externality is not at all applicable in the context of transboundary pollution or international externalities. It requires cooperation or international agreement. All the countries should take responsibility to reduce the pollution. However, even though all nations, they have a common interest to reduce their pollution, at the private level, no country has an incentive to reduce the pollution at their own cost, because global climate, global environment is like a global public good. Irrespective of whether a country cooperates or not, no country can be denied or no country can be prevented to enjoy the benefit from the abatement activities taken by others. So we have analyzed the situation in terms of a game theory, a simple model. So ideally, each country should equate their marginal cost of abatement with the global marginal damage cost. So that is the global benefit. So if each country equates their cost with the global benefit, then we will arrive at this situation, QC, higher level of abatement. However, since each country has an incentive to deviate, each country has an incentive to non-cooperation, it will lead to QN level of abatement. That means country will equate MSC J with MDC J only. Jth country is bothered only its own cost and benefit. In terms of this payoff matrix, simple payoff matrix, even though low level of pollution, that means cooperation is beneficial for country 1 and 2, because of the existence of a dominant strategy of non-cooperation, it leads to a situation wherein the countries are getting only Pareto suboptimal benefits. Okay, so suboptimal benefits, that means it is difficult to achieve cooperation even though it is beneficial for both of them. Then economists, they could think of a side payment wherein the countries who get benefit out of this global cooperation, they must compensate the other countries who are getting loss out of it, who are worse off. If the global benefit is higher than the loss of some specific countries, but such side payments should be credibly designed. It must be credible enough to convince all the countries, particularly the poorer countries, developing and underdeveloped countries, that yes, if we also take part in this global cooperation, then there are countries who will compensate us for such activities. So that is the solution for controlling global climate change, controlling transboundary pollution. With this, we are closing our discussion today. Thank you.